Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Good weekend, all. Ira Epstein of Linn & Associates with your metals market update. And this is our weekend version for Friday. And this is the 7th of September, 2018, and the markets are all closed behind me. Now, remember on the weekend version, what we try to do is look at first a monthly chart and then go to the weekly charts rather than the daily charts. And the rationale there is just trying to get a bigger picture. Now, the big thing in the event of the week has been the emerging markets going into, in many cases, bear market territory around the world, worried that the Fed is going to raise interest rates, which it certainly looks like it after the jobs data we saw today, at another 201,000 jobs. We kept our unemployment rate at 3.9%. Productivity's picking up, and the lower-end salaries are picking up to a degree, which should keep the Fed right on pace. Where the Fed could get thrown off, even though there's a strong probability for a December hike, is what to do if we get into worse situations with these emerging markets and everything around the U.S. should look like this, and they start cratering. And that would be the problem. And while people say that's not their mandate, it is. Stability becomes the mandate. As long as inflation weren't picking up, it comes into play. Now, how it would come into play, I don't have a crystal ball, but you've got to think about it. The stock market down today, fractions in the S&P, the Dow, and the NASDAQ, they were down a lot more than this. Late in the day, there was some news that maybe the U.S. and Canada are getting closer to an agreement to pick the market off the lows. Russell was able to close a little higher, but in the metals, we had a pretty across-the-board down day. So let's take a look at what's going on. If you look at the monthly chart, you went to the upper bands throughout 2000, right here, from 2017 to 18, and all of a sudden, for the first time, we're challenging the lows from the 2016 time frame. So the market is trying to break out to the downside. Momentum is down, bias is down. It doesn't have the pattern of lower highs, lower lows, but that's all that it's missing. But what it's done is it's gone to the lower Bollinger Bands. Bollinger Bands are these black dashed lines. And it's an algorithm designed to make the market trade within them 95% of the time. The problem is when they go sideways and they narrow in, unlike what you see right here when they were channeling to the upside, from here it's like a spring action. They wind the price pressure. And it's a monthly chart, remember that. So it's a lot of time. And if it breaks down, it goes like a son of a gun. So it's something to watch. There is nothing I see on this chart that turns the market bullish right away. When I look at a weekly area chart of closes, we went from 1352 to 1161, got a bounce. That bounce carried last week the close to 1206.20, and now the market is breaking down again, 2 weeks in a row. What would turn the market friendly is closing over this 1206 level. I would then start arguing you've got pattern of a low and then higher lows and a higher close over that. However, until you'd close over the 18-week average, the bias would still be down. When I take a look at the just a weekly bar chart and put on this a swing line, well, you've got a pattern now of a high that took out this high and a low that took out that one. So we don't have a trend. We're out of the trend of lower highs, lower lows. The market's been so far unable to challenge the 200-week moving average of closes. The 100-week is here, but you had something bearish happen recently. Right through here, you've got the 18-week under the 100-week. That is a bear pattern. And once that's set in, you can see how the market's looking at that. If you get this number, the 18-week under the 200, that adds another bearish level to it. So you keep your eye on that. Resistance in between these numbers, 1233.30 and 1247.80. In terms of Bollinger Bands, the market had been riding the lower Bollinger Bands, finally bounced away, and now the market is ready to say, okay, what next? Momentum tried to turn up, and it's done a miserable job. It is momentum that has no bounce to it so far. Normally, you get momentum once it gets into oversold territory or turns back up, doing something like that, and with it, price goes. You didn't get that. You got like a, okay, I'm a bear. I'll give you a little bounce, and I'm going to pull back. And that's what it's done. I think you need to get over 1217 on a closing basis on the weekly chart to say maybe the market will get some oomph and be able to rally back to these two areas. In the gold-silver ratio, this is not what market turns in metals are made of. This is exactly not what it is. When the gold keeps gaining on the silver, it's rare that gold makes a bottom. Got it? Go back and do your history. When you look at the GLD ETF, the weekly chart, it's bearish. Lower highs, lower lows, momentum still bearish. For those of you that watch my daily bar, my daily videos, I don't treat slow stochastics on weekly charts the way that I do on daily. I just look at it as a bearish or bullish, and it is still very much in the bear camp. GDX, bearish as can be there, lower highs, lower lows, a new low close for the whole move, in fact. So still very much in the bear camp here. In the silver, lower highs, lower lows. Now, what silver has going for it is it closed under the lower Bollinger Band. And you don't generally close out of these black dashed lines more than 5% of the time. So the odds favor somewhere along the line here. It's going to get another bounce. But it's a bounce. It's not a change of trend. To negate the downtrend on this chart, you got to take out this last rally high of 1495. Momentum's not saying that'll happen. There's nothing bullish here. In copper, is this market going to reach through the 255.20 level? No reason why not. Lower highs, lower lows. The chart is still bearish. The bias is down. You could even get another level of super bearishness by getting the 18-week average under the 100-week soon. They're only 5 cents apart. And they've been tracking at the point, as you can see, losing about 100 points each week. So I don't think it's going to do it on Sunday night, but it's getting closer and closer. Obviously, this has been hurt ever since the trade wars with the U.S. Take a look at the peak in the copper. That's when the problems began. And as our president keeps talking more tariffs on China, that's in their good trade because we're a big customer. Let's not forget that. That's a problem, and it's going to create a loss of copper demand, I think. The good news is the copper mines are talking of not producing as much copper, so you're getting something of a balance instead of a price crash. Lower highs, lower lows in the platinum, still bearish, momentum down, bias down. And in the palladium, this is the strongest of the metal markets. On the daily charts, it's very clear. This chart never put in what I'll call the pattern of higher lows, higher highs. But it has been the standout. It is the metal up for the week. The others are not. And in the dollar, you're at a crossroads right here. You have divergence on this chart. What is divergence? You've got a pattern of higher lows, higher highs, bullish. You're over the 18-week average, bullish, but momentum's pointing down. That's the divergence. So it's going to be interesting to see what the market does. If it can break through this 100-week average with any oomph to it, then I'm looking for the 96.57. If the market fails and starts breaking through right here, this 94.34, you could get actually a pattern here that is lower highs, lower lows. So what's the key on the chart? Not getting back under 94.34. I'll talk about this in my own research. And then the Linn Group does a phenomenal job of giving you points on charts, research, talks about fundamentals, all the different things if you're a metals trader that you'd want to get ideas of. Then we do something with what we call price counts and option strategies for you. And you choose the markets you want. If you're a metals trader, you choose the metals. What do you need to take a look at what the softs are doing or the grains? Why fill up your mailbox, your inbox, and your email? Choose the markets you want. Let us show you what our customers get. And no, you're not going to get on a list and stay there unless you do business with us. It's really that simple. How do you get this? You can either call my staff. You can go to our website. On our website, you'll see a carousel of free offers. It rotates on the front page. Click one. Choose what you want and away you go. Or you can click up here. If you're watching me on YouTube, it'll take you right to that page. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a great day, and I'll see you all on Monday.